What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Jodabeni. I'm an electrical engineer, and today I'm going to be discussing, are you too old to become an electrical engineer? You may be in a position in your life today that you don't like what you do, or maybe you're just interested or curious about the electrical engineering field, but then a second thought comes to your head and you tell yourself, hey, am I actually still young enough to do this? You know, is my age going to be a problem with me getting a job even when I go through college and get an electrical engineering degree? The most valuable asset that an engineer carries is their mind. The knowledge you carry, the problem solving skills that you can use in the work field is what companies love. And that's irrelevant to your age. So let's take a look at other reasons that can help you understand whether you are too old to become an electrical engineer. First and foremost thing I'd like to say is no one can make you feel inferior without your own consent. It doesn't matter what your mom says, your dad, your cousin, your teacher. It doesn't matter what you tell yourself at the end of the day, because it's possible to become an electrical engineer. And if you're a negative thinker about yourself, if you're always thinking negatively about what you can do, it's going to happen. So the first things first is you have to change your mindset that you can do it, that you can become an electrical engineer. That is a primary step into being successful. Don't look at your age as a barrier. Don't look at all these other circumstances that are not going to benefit you as an electrical engineer. If you have the determination, you can succeed no matter your age. Overseas, they take 15-year-olds, 16-year-olds to do work that adult electrical engineers do here in the States. If a 15-year-old can do what adults are doing, then you, as somebody who's already been an adult for a significant amount of time, can definitely do it. The second thing is most companies have new grad programs. If you go to apply for a new electrical engineering job or even any other engineering jobs, a lot of these big companies offer grad-only positions. Yes, they want somebody who's fresh out of college so that they can indoctrinate them into their method of business model. And also, whenever you hire brand new grads, you don't have to pay them as much as those who have experience. So there will always be jobs for new graduates. Yes, with the economy the way it is today, it makes it a lot harder to get jobs, but it also depends what field you pick. It took me about 2 months to get my first electrical engineering job after I graduated. But when you look at my graduation class, there was 15 students. I went to University of the Rio Grande Valley. There was 15 of us that graduated with an electrical engineering degree. On the other side, software engineering, I'm pretty sure there was over 100 students getting their computer science degree. Now, with all these students getting their computer science degrees, that leaves a lot of room for those who want to become electrical engineers. So if you started today going to school and getting your electrical engineering degree, by the time you finish, I can guarantee that you'll have a much easier time getting a position than somebody who goes to a computer science field, because there's just way more competition there. And these new grad programs don't care about age. There's no age limit. This isn't a U18, a U19 sports league. This is electrical engineering. They care about your mind, your most valuable asset. How can you apply what you learned in college into our work field? That is how you get a job in this field. The third thing is the value and experience somebody who is older brings into the market. When an employer is looking between two potential employees to hire, there's two new grads, right? One, you have been an adult for the past 20 years. You have experience at different companies, and the company you're currently at, you've been there for the past maybe 7-8 years, while the new college grad has never worked a job in his life. So this will be his first adult job outside of college. Right off the bat, the company already sees that, hey, this worker is somebody who doesn't job hops. He has a lot of experience. He's seasoned into the professional world, and they're probably going to take you much more serious than somebody who's brand new out of college, who's still wet behind the ears. And the older you are, the more accountable you are for things in your life, because at this point in your life, you may have kids, children, wife, house, mortgage payments, and they know it's much harder for you to job hop because you've got to stay in certain places to keep the stability in your home. People get caught up in comparing sports with work life. It's not the same. Yes, I can see why people can feel that, hey, maybe if I'm too old, I will get looked upon in the work field, because yes, whenever we get older, sometimes our mind starts to deteriorate, but that's not the first thing an employer sees. right? He's not going to say, oh, look at this old man who thinks he can be an engineer. No, if anything, usually the old people we find in the workplace are usually one of the brightest people because they're just so seasoned. And even if they're not the best engineer, they definitely bring value into the group by their life experiences. So you just got to sit back and think to yourself, what's it going to look like 10 years from now after I graduate and I look back? Is it going to be a vision of you saying, man, I regret getting an electrical engineering degree? Or are you going to look back and be like, thank God I actually did it? And you're going to be proud of yourself and you're going to have that plaque, your diploma hanging up on the wall, something that makes you feel good that you accomplished one of the hardest engineering fields in the world. The fifth thing is, nobody's coming to save you. Let's be real. If you want your life to change, it's up to you, right? There's no excuses that you're going to make that's going to help you become an electrical engineer. The only thing you can sit back and think about is, how can I accomplish this task? How can I graduate and become an electrical engineer? I know this because I've been there before. Whenever I went to college initially, I got a business degree, right? I was so confident that, hey, this is what I wanted to do. But then I started learning about the field of electrical engineering and I started to grow interest into it. And the first thing that I used to feed myself is, man, I'm already in debt. School is not worth it. Or I'd say, man, I'm already headed towards 25. Going back to college at this point is gonna put me behind. Like, you know, you'll see your friends graduating. Some of them are being way more successful than you are. Some aren't, but you're surrounded by all these things going on in your life. And you might be thinking to yourself, hey, maybe this is too late for me, right? But ultimately it came to what I had to decide. It was irrelevant to what my previous grades were. Maybe math wasn't my strong suit whenever I finished my business degree, right? Math wasn't my strong suit. But at the time I finished my electrical engineering degree, math was my strong suit. I didn't have a choice. And it was a decision that I had to make and commit to completing my degree. Don't get me wrong, it wasn't easy. It was tough every single step of the way, but now that I'm here, I don't regret it one bit. The only thing I can do now is help you guys who are new into this field and maybe showing you guys tips and tricks that would have helped me propel much farther. Because in the electrical engineering field, a lot of the people you're gonna meet aren't very social. So a lot of us are stuck learning the ins and outs of it on our own. That's why I made this channel, to help you guys. And you know, you could always leave a like and subscribe, and it helps me a lot as well. So ultimately, if you're asking yourself, are you too old to become an electrical engineer? Ask yourself, where is that coming from? Is that coming from a sense of fear? A sense of lack? Why are you telling yourself that? Why are you even asking yourself that? If God has already put something on your mind, that means it has a purpose for you. So if you're already thinking to yourself, man, am I too old to become an electrical engineer? No, you're not too old. You can definitely commit to it today. I graduated with my electrical engineering degree with my bachelor's. I didn't think I'd ever go back to school. I remember telling myself, you know what, that's it, that's wraps. Like, I'm never going back. And today, in my second semester for my master's degree, and life changes, people change. And if it's something in your heart, go after it and go conquer the world. And I'll see you guys in the next video. If you enjoyed this video and you made it this far, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe button. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Jodabeni's out.